Hi, it's Friday. We'll eventually get used to doing vlogs again and not forget that we need to end the vlog.
I'm just a girl, a wonderful
Good
girl.
morning. Happy June 5th. It is shipping day for me, which is why I have no makeup on my face. But I have shipping from my YouTube sale and my Vamp sale, but I also have a couple eBay sales last night, so I'm gonna pull those for you. These girls. These are the little Dion quintuplets. I paid $15 for them at an antique show, flea market. Sold them on eBay for $90. So, or 95. I'll pop it up on the screen. But they're in excellent condition. These are little girls are worth some money. They really are, especially when they're complete. I also sold a coin. That I've had listed for a very long time. This guy. The Terminator. It's from the 70s. It's a some sort, not really a coin. It's more of a, well, you'd wear it on a necklace, I guess. I don't know. But those two things sold on eBay. So we're gonna get those shipped as well as the well, all of this stuff over here. All of that. All of that, all of that. But before we do that, we'll do our affirmations. And then after I get my shipping done, I am planning on working a little bit later tonight. So after I get my shipping done, I'm gonna set up a tripod. I'm gonna start working on pricing some more things for the pop-up because I've got to do that. And I'm just sitting here thinking, I need more space. It's just really hard to know what like Miss Pamela and what Ariana and Michael and Barb and Fatbirds, like how many things are bringing. So once everybody is here, I think Michael's gonna come early and set up some stuff, but it's gonna be, we'll be able to intermingle our items a little bit, but it's just kind of weird. Just like there's a shelf over there, but I can't use that yet, that kind of thing. Anyhow, we'll get it all figured out. But I'm gonna set up a tripod and I'm gonna start making some more vignettes. And when I'm done, then I'll kind of explain to you what I've done, I think. I think that's what I'm gonna do. All right, let's read affirmation alert. June 5th, right? Yeah, June 5th. Who decides what you deserve? What do you deserve? How does it make you feel to say out loud what you deserve? If you don't care what anyone else thought, then what might you deserve? Gosh, that's something to think about. Because sometimes we don't want to say it out loud because then we feel like we're being a little selfish or a little self-centered. Are there consistencies or inconsistencies in your answers to the three previous questions? If so, notice them. Then choose to acknowledge that what you deserve is your decision, and regardless of what you decide you deserve, you are worthy of it. So let's see. What do you deserve? How does it make you feel to say that out loud? And if you don't care what anyone else thought, what might you deserve? That's an interesting one to think about, I have to say. All right, our daily affirmators. Today, I'll notice all the little ways I'm loved, nurtured, and supported. Go ahead, universe. That's your cue. It's a cute little card. Those aren't my favorite ones, though. They're not very, these other ones I think are gonna be a little bit better. In fact, I'm thinking what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna throw that one away. I'm just gonna include those in here. And if I pull one of those, then that's fine. But these other ones I got, I don't remember where I got them. I think I got them from the antique mall. They're also affirmators, 30 affirmation cards to help yourself without self-helpiness, which is what the other one said, but I don't like those as much. These seem to be a little bit more better. More better, that's a word. All right, we're gonna stick those. I'm gonna shove those inside and we'll shuffle those the next time we do them. Okay, well, I'm gonna get started on, oh, affirmation's over. I'm gonna get to start on shipping and then I'll come back and check in. Good morning. It is the sixth day of June
And I didn't do any more pricing of the things for the pop-up yesterday. I just shipped all day and then I went home. So today I'm gonna start doing some pricing and pulling and showing you a little bit of things that I'm gonna be putting out in for the pop-up. I also need to, the Blitz is this weekend, starting on Sunday, June 9th, the Blitz 7, where we have all new Vamp live sellers that are going to be coming on. I'm going to be working on that. I've got some listings that I'm going to be working on, so I'll give you a little bit of preview. I've got Lucite candles, I've got Christmas, I've got some mini swungs, I've got some cool things. So I will do a little bit of preview of that once I get that going. But I also had Stinker Fred asked me if I had any bittersweet for sale. So Stinker Fred bought this. I have a bigger one that's, it comes about up to here on me. But I said it's like the size of a human, so I don't really want to ship that one. This one's more manageable to ship. So Stinker Fred bought this from me. But my big, big, big bittersweet floor vase is going to be at the pop-up. But then Stinker Fred said, I said, Stinker Fred, there's more bittersweet over on Vamp. And Stinker Fred went over to Vamp and he got some more bittersweet. We need to change his name to Angel Fred. But Fred, Stinker Fred, Angel Fred also bought this guy. Screwed again. And he bought, I Made an Impression in Daytona Beach. It's for your butt. It's a butt. And then this, which honestly is one of my favorite things. So Fred, you did good on this because this is great. This is a little single shaker, but it is from the farmer's market. Hollywood, California. It's a souvenir piece. Probably from the 1940s. I don't know. This is the box that I bought it in, so I'm going to keep it in this box and ship it to Fred in that box. But I thought that was pretty cool. So I think you did good on that, Fred. I think that's an excellent piece of, well, if you like Hollywood memorabilia and that sort of thing. So I love that a lot, Fred. Okay. Another thing I'm wanting to do real quick. You know what? Let me grab our affirmations. It's good. This is kind of a two-day vlog, so if you don't like the affirmations, I'm sorry. But I warn you when I'm doing them, and you can scroll away. But I think after we do our affirmations, and I have something I want to open here real quick. I have to go to the post office today, too. We are going to, I'm going to ship that big, I'm going to show you how I ship that big stubby swung vase. Okay, before we do our affirmations though, I want to do a little bit of an unboxing here. Dossier, I already actually opened up one of these boxes because I couldn't wait. I wanted to smell it. Dossier has sent me these perfumes to do as a review. So I've got three different scents and I will link Dossier's below. I've actually gotten a few things from Dossier a few times. They do like dupes of really expensive perfumes and colognes, so at a fraction of the price. And I mean, they don't spend a lot of money on their merchandising, their packaging. So it's very simple. They're able to get these to you at a fraction of the price of the major brands here, and the quality is just as good, and there's not the huge markups. So I've got this floral violet. And you can see, I'll pop up on the screen the name of the dupe, but I've had this one before. This one's like I think this is the Marc Jacobs Daisy. Actually, Emma wants this one. Golly, it smells so good. So the floral violet is a dupe of the Marc Jacobs Daisy. And I like how the little, it's a magnetic. So like if you are traveling, that is really good. But this stays with you all day and it smells exactly like it. Oh, here, we got a little card here. Good grief, Misty. This is inspired by Marc Jacobs Daisy. It's 20% concentration and it is fantastic. So I will link Dossier. So that is one of them. And then they sent me a big one. This is a big one. So this is, I'll show you the difference in the sizes. This one here is inspired by Carolina Herrera Good Girl Era. So this one's a larger bottle. You can see the two different sizes. But again, there's, it's that little magnetic. So this is like a, yeah, this is like an almondy peach. Here, smell it. Almondy peach smell. I don't want to spray this on me since I just did the Marc Jacobs. I don't want to spray this one on my body since I already sprayed the other one. Yeah, it's a very clean, light floral scent. Carolina Herrera dupe. And then I wanted to try this one. This one is a, it's for men or women. Don't you guys remember CK1? Remember that was like a gender fluid scent? And I loved it, but this one isn't that. I probably should have looked to see if they had this, but this one is Sunny Vintivir and Neroli. It's a smaller one, and it is supposed to be a unisex. And this says it is woody and floral. Now, I think that this one might be a Dossier exclusive, Dossier original. Yeah, that's what that said. So this one is, to me, this one smells a little bit more masculine than feminine, which is good for Mark because Mark will wear it, but it is like a woodsy smell. I prefer more of the florals than like the woodsy, musty smells. So that one's going to go to Mark. But check Dossier out if you love perfumes and you want them at a fraction of the price. You don't have to, you know, pay for the markups. So give Dossier a try, and I will link them down in the description. I must smell good all day today. Thank you, Dossier. Hey, that rhymed. I'm gonna smell good today. Thank you, Dossier. All right, now let's do our affirmations. Today's June 6th, and it says, an exercise for shame. Shame is a powerful emotion that you can use to your advantage. Why are you ashamed of? Could you turn that shame into a powerful statement of acceptance instead? For example, what if instead saying, I'm ashamed of growing up poor, you said, growing up in poverty is what has motivated me to work hard and to have a deep appreciation for all that I own. Using our shame this way allows us to thrive and move forward boldly. Give it a try. Don't, you can, you grow through what you go through. I think we've said that before. All right, we got these new affirmator cards because those other ones, I mean, I have them mixed in here, but we'll see if these are better. They got like a magical unicorn on this side. So this says inspiration. There is a voice of inspiration within me. Right now, it's only a whisper, but the more I listen, the louder it will get. Soon, it will be a flawless speech voiced by James Earl Jones through a megaphone with lots of applause. That little voice inside your head saying, don't look back, you can never go back. Okay, we're not going to break out into 80s songs, but okay, I'll put that in as a package topper, but let's go over here and let's ship Stinker Fred's Angel Fred. Let's ship his vase. And he also got those three things from me, and I will be able to combine. He bought that from me, but I can combine shipping for him. So he, and then what, if there's any overages, I'll refund his money. So, okay. All right, let me get the camera. Actually, I don't know. We'll see if this tripod, maybe we can use this tripod over here. Let's go over here. Oh, I also have to pull things for next Tuesday's sale. All right, so this big boy, I told Stinker Fred I'd give him a measurement, but 19 and a half inches. So what I'm gonna do with him is I'm gonna fill his void with paper, and I've got, whenever I get packages and stuff, I save all that paper, and then we use it to use as filler. We're gonna fill our void. I'm also gonna protect, see, I don't have a lot of phobia over shipping. I know a lot of people do, but once you're doing it a lot, it really does become kind of second nature to you. Like, I know I gotta protect these fingers. That's what I call them, fingers. And so we're just gonna wrap it. We're just gonna continuously wrap it. We're gonna pack it real nice. So basically you're filling the void, and then any kind of weak points, like this, like finger that goes above the rest, we're gonna kind of extra cushion that. Like a pre-cushion, if you will. We try not to over tape, because that's really kind of annoying. If you get a package and it takes you 15 years to unwrap it, that's not fun. I'm also going to see now. Maybe we need to move you down a little bit. Well, the head, my top of my head's cut off, but I'm going to use some paper just to wrap around it, just to protect it a little bit from any being rubbed against, any nicks. And it does, believe it or not, it does provide wrapping a breakable item in paper a little bit first does provide another a little layer of cushion. I know it's not much, but it's something. Okay, now. See, now I think I want to use my other tripod so you could see from above. We just lay out some bubble wrap. We got to move Fred's other items. And then, oh goodness gracious, you're going for a big ride. I'm going to put you on this other tripod. There, see? That's better. You get more of an angle. I'm gonna lay her down and very gently we're going to tuck and roll this first layer. It's a good idea just to make sure that your bubble wrap is all spread out if you've got a dining room table or even on the floor. You know, you just don't want to, you got to be gentle. You don't want to clank it around. Tuck and roll every now and then. We're just singing 80s songs. There we are. Tape it there at the bottom. I'm going to flip it on its side and gather this. Tape it. Now, this is just the way that I do shipping. There are other people who ship large vases and heavier items, and they have their own method that works for them. And you'll start to figure that out. And you'll start to, you know, feel safe in, you know, your packing abilities. All right, so that's layer one. I'm gonna take some more American Bubble Boy bubble wrap. And since this, I'm not necessarily worried. Oh. I just discovered that my camera has tracking. But why is it so zoomed in? Oh, okay. Hang on, I don't like that. So what I was saying is with these vases, your weak point is like this. Down here, it's pretty solid, but your weak points are the neck of it. So I'm gonna lay it on its side like this, and I'm just gonna put another couple layers until I feel that it's well protected. Sometimes people will put cardboard, they'll put some sort of a bracing on it. I don't do that, but that's not to say that it's not a good idea. And I do tape, but not too, I'm not taking my tape and rolling it around and around. I know some people like the Saran method. That's not my favorite either, because that makes it a little hard. Makes it hard to unwrap as well.
All right, I'm actually gonna put another layer up towards that top. We kind of did the middle. Now, is this a lot of packing material? You bet your darn Skippy ride it is. But you know what? That's the price of selling breakable items, is you have to have the shipping material. That's why sometimes, you know, people are like, well, why can't you sell it for cheaper? Well, I've got a little bit of money in my shipping material. So those are all things that you have to consider when you're buying items for resale, is the amount of packing material that it can take. I don't like the way that bottom feels, so I'm going to go ahead and put another layer on the bottom. It's like a little, it's like I'm wrapping up a little baby vase. Sorry, stinker foot, but I'm gonna put tape on those corners too. Okay. A little baby, don't say a word. Okay. Now, I feel good about that. And I got, you know, this vase without being in a box is 21 inches tall. So the biggest hurdle of them all isn't the wrapping of the vases. It's getting the box. It's finding the box. The box is sometimes the more troubling matter. All right, I'm gonna see what I can find. All right, Mark got me these boxes from work, and they are thick. They're thick. So, and it doesn't fit, you know, the vase doesn't fit like all the way side by side. So I'm going to double box it. So I've got these other things that Fred has ordered. So I'll put paper in it, and I'm gonna put the vase upright like this, shove it full of paper, all that recycled paper, and then this box will fit on top, and then we'll tape it together. So it'll be double boxed in these really heavy duty thick boxes. Again, tape, this box was free, but I do order my boxes for the most part. So your tape, your packing material, your boxes, it all adds up into the cut of the profits that you're making. So again, that is something to make sure that you are paying attention to. Yes, I can make money on that, but how much materials is it going to cost me in supplies to ship it? So I guess just think about those things. All right, I'm gonna get going. I'm gonna leave the camera on. I'm just gonna speed it up, and yeah, then when we're done, we'll pop back in. A lot of tape. You need to pack your item. Like I could throw this across the room and I would feel like it would break. So that's, you have to pack your items to be, you know, drop kicked, because that's what sometimes happens. One thing you want to make sure, like I said, since Mark got these from work, I want to make sure you can peel the stickers off if you want. I don't. I'm not messing with that. I'm just gonna make sure that any things with barcodes or, well, obviously you want to take your own address off of things, but we want to make sure, because I've actually made the mistake of not doing that, and the thing that I had shipped out came back to me because it had my address on it still. So don't do that. But I feel good about this. Now I just need to get the measurement and the weight. All right, Stinker Fred, you got goodies coming to you. I'm going to get it shipped out to you today. All right, I'm checking in. I've been listing a bunch of things, but I did have an eBay sale. These cute little baby shoes. They're from Gertrude's. No, Crawford Shoe Company, Mattoon, Illinois. But they are little baby saddle shoes in their original box. So those sold, so I'm going to get those ready to go. But these are the things that I have been listing on Vamp for the Blitz, which is Sunday and Monday. I've got some Victorian shakers, some anthropomorphic, Lucite candles, Carnival vase, Fenton. No, actually, your Northwood. This is a Kewpie. So, some Christmas, some Westmoreland. So, just kind of a variety, some Mackinac things, fortune-telling things, Missy Mouse, Viking, Garfield, these playing cards. And I loved this. Be unique with that hand-painted giraffe. I just like that. So, a lot of great sellers that are going to be on there. So, I'm going to get this ready to go and then I'm going to sit down and continue to list items. I have a meeting tonight at 5 with my Vamp sellers. So we'll do that at 5. And I'm going to stay here and work a little bit later. I am. By the time that you see this, he'll already be home. But Mark's been in Boston all week. So I've been a girl unsupervised. And I've been working late. I don't have anybody telling me that I have to come home. I don't have anybody telling me that I need to stop working. And I've been getting some stuff done. I don't feel like I have been, but I have been. Okay, I'm going to get these shipped. I'm going to keep listing. Hi, it's Friday. We'll eventually get used to doing vlogs again and not forget that we need to end the vlog. And we'll get there eventually. I had a sale on eBay last night. And it was the squirrel family. And your babies. Come on, guys. You're going to go on a journey. We are? A journey? Yes. A journey to your new home. So, I'm going to get this shipped off out. It's an eBay sale. But, I have got my sights. Well, let me turn this light on so you can see. My sale for the Blitz. These items will be in Sunday night. This coming Sunday night. Which you're watching this on Saturday. So, tomorrow night on Vamp, the Blitz. I've got a Kitsch. I've got Victorian glass. I've got some swung vases. I have got some Fenton, some Westmoreland, Shafford, Christmas, anthropomorphic, old maid, fortune telling cards, Lucite. It's a wild gamut of all things, well, different, of different eras and styles. I've taken all these pictures. I'm gonna work on getting the listings up for Monday night's Blitz. I've got some Viking, some more pieces. I actually brought a couple more pieces that I'm gonna add to it. So, oh, and look what I broke, these two things. Oh, just makes me wanna cry. I will glue them and I will try and I will repair them and they'll still at least sit even on my shelf for a little while. I'm so sorry, Mr. Elephant. You fell off and you're a little, but actually she just cut me. You just cut me, girl. She's like, that's what you get. Look, she made me bleed. That's what you get for breaking me, Misty. It's what you get. I didn't mean to, but we'll put these over here because when I say we will fix it, I mean Mark. Because here, I'll put him next to this other guy that needs fixed. He just comes in and there's just things. Move over, Moss Man. Moss Man, you guys know who Moss Man is, right? He's from Masters of the Universe. Look! Well, I'm going to go wash the blood off of my hands and I'm going to pack up this item. And then I'm going to show you the things that I'm going to be selling in Tuesday's YouTube sale. If I don't lose all my blood first. Okay, so I just wanted to show you a little bit of a preview of some of the items that I'm going to be bringing to my Tuesday sale with Michael, the Cult of Vintage. This one is a Lefton Bluebird. This one, it was one that Cracker Barrel did several years ago. So those are going to be coming. Cleaner Kate. I clean your house real good. you can keep your scouring powder in her, if you want. And then these girls I'm selling, they were my collections for a while, but these girls, I've got some hankies. I've got, oh, Canada napkin holder. Who remembers this? Oh my gosh, I don't know. I may have to keep this. Okay, I'm going to keep this for a future grandchild. I had that when I was little too, and it has all the components on the inside. So we're not going to sell that. I've got orange Lucite candles and green. This little, I think you're F&B. Yeah, F&B half pint. Hi, I'm half pint. High five. My, one of my favorites, this Elizabeth Gordon book. This was I Wonder Why. It's got great illustrations in it. Oh my gosh, Things at Night. It's so cute. And then the Water Babies by Charles Kingsley. This one's illustrated in color by Jesse Wilcox Smith. You see, I had to put a band-aid on my little finger. So the Water Baby story, I wanted to show you. Ooh. Ew. There is a collar plate right there. Oh, aren't they sweet? They hugged and they kissed each other for ever so long. They did not know why. Look at the fish back there. So that and one of my blue balls. Do you like my blue ball? I have another one. I thought I needed a bigger one, but I don't. I already have one. Oh, man. Okay, Missy, you don't need to have another one. I'm going to wait. I might take that home and put it with my other balls. And so I don't know if I'm going to do these teak candle holders. I might sell them with these orange ones possibly. Look how cool that looks. I love those candlesticks. And then I've got clear glass cat, meow meow, and blue cat, meow meow. I've got a red bird. It is all red. It's not flash painted. It's Amberina. I've got a couple more of these Victorian milk glass, blue milk glass shakers. Oh, look at this fabulousness. This pebble art. It's got an M on it for marvelous. Or Misty. Got a little Fenton hobnail bowl. This Ingram daisy clock. It does work. Oh, and I went through and I did my gallery wall, but I had so much of this patriotic sheet music, so I thought I'd do a lot. That one's not patriotic. Hang on. Let me get to the patriotic ones. There we go. That one. Don't fence me in. So I'm going to sell these as a lot. I'm thinking that maybe, wait, is that one a double? That one's a double. So we'll put that one over here. Maybe somebody would want to make their own gallery wall. So we'll do those. I'll put these over another area. But so those are the things that are going to be available in Tuesday's live sale. There might be a few other things too. Since I moved those over to the side. Oh, I'm going to end this vlog. This was kind of all over the place, but I've got to get back into the swing of things for vlogging, which I am going to do starting on Monday. I'm going to start vlogging and really start showing you the things that I'm doing in the pop-up to get you prepared for that. I'm thinking about doing something maybe a little special Friday night before the pop-up when everyone is here, right before Flippin' and Sippin'. Flippin' and Sippin' is going to happen Friday night when Mary Beth and Laura are here, so that's gonna be a lot of fun. It's just a lot of work to do, and I just feel like I'm trying to do 15 different things regarding the pop-up and then the Misty Show, Thrifter Junker Vintage Hunter, Vamp, getting things ready for my live sales. It's just doing all of the shipping, editing the videos. It's just a lot, but I love it so much. I do. I am not trying to complain like, oh, I'm doing this. I love it. I just wish that there were more hours in the day. That's all I wish. If there could just be that. That would be great. Okay, I'm gonna go, but thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.
Red hot mama, red hot mama, you're the one we need. Red hot mama, some charmer, yes indeed. Say that I should be in the Follies, hot tamales. Say that I got a pair of eyes just like old Svengali's. I confess that I possess the sweetest charms in town. And unless I miss my guess, the boys will follow me around. I could make a music master, drop his fiddle, make a bald-headed man part of his.